Welcome to this Fast15 on Workday, requesting time off. In this webinar, I'm going to show you the absence functions of Workday, how to request time off, how that process is routed through Workday, and I'll show you the calendar functions within the program. When you log into Workday, on your homepage, under your applications, you'll see the absence function. When I want to request some time off, I will start with this absence app. When the screen loads, I have two options on the left-hand side. I can request an absence or correct an absence I've already submitted. On the right-hand side, I have my leave balances as of today. This is also the application I'd use for any submissions and requests for time off under the Family and Medical Leave Act, otherwise known as FMLA and OFLA. These are on a case-by-case basis, and you should be working through HR on those processes. But Workday will still show me how many hours of those different medical leaves and family leaves I have available, in addition to basic leave balances, including personal business, sick leave, straight time, and vacation leave. Even though we can track and manage our time off in Workday, Workday does not replace our state payroll system. At the end of the month or end of the pay period, we still need to go into ePayroll and complete our time card. Workday, however, does have a link to ePayroll, the OSPA website link, so when you are done looking at your absence, you can go in and submit your timesheet. Within Absence, on the left-hand side, simply click on Request Absence to start your request for time off. Workday will then present to you a calendar view where you can select a date range, where you can view your team and view your team absences, and your coworkers can see on their team calendar if you have taken time off. And you can also see if there's anybody else on your team who might be taking leave or time off at the same time as you. I can select specific workers, or if I simply click OK, I can see the team calendar with my leave requests overlaid. Now, I've already submitted a couple different leave requests here in this example and have a couple approvals. But in this example, I don't see anybody on my team that has actually requested time off. If I did, I would simply see their name and I would only see if it was approved. But I wouldn't see if they, for example, had sick leave, medical leave, military leave. I wouldn't see any of those leave types. I would simply know that they were out that day. When I'm ready to request an absence, I click on the button to select a date range. For this example, I'm just going to highlight a future date on my calendar by dragging across calendar days. I can also click on the days themselves, or I can click and drag to highlight. For this example, I'm going to request 5 days off, a week of vacation, on the date selected. Once I've selected any dates, Workday will allow me to click on the orange Request Absence button and select the type of leave I'm going to use. I want to look for a vacation leave, but I do essentially have most of the leave options available to me as a state employee, such as jury duty, family and medical leave, military leave, interview leave, and even leave without pay. Since I'm taking vacation, I'll go ahead and select the vacation option. Workday should automatically populate my position, and I will click Next. The next screen will show me a day by day, or in this case, since I'd select a block of time, a row of the actual hours I'm requesting. Workday will default and say I'm taking full days off. But let's say I'm not taking this whole week. I can click on Edit Quantity Per Day, and if needed, change how many hours that I am actually requesting. And I can put in any comments. And if I was doing a partial day, let's say I only took an afternoon off, I would want to put in these comments the exact time that I want to take off so my manager can review that. I could also change the quantity per day. For example, if I'm on a different shift, different work schedule, such as 4-10s or 4-9s and a 4. Once I'm ready and have all my days and hours ready to submit, I can enter overall comments about this request. For example, if my supervisor approved this verbally, maybe we just had a normal conversation, and my supervisor told me to go follow up with the official request, I could put that in the comments and then click Submit. When I submit, Workday returns me back to my calendar. I'll see my vacation a block of time from March 4th through March 8th. However, it will be in a gray color. Gray means I've submitted a request for time off and it has not yet been approved. I can click on the request itself through the calendar, which pulls up the details of the request, and if needed, I can cancel it before it's approved. perhaps my plans changed, or I decided not to take a vacation at all. Before it's approved, I can cancel the request. Once I hit that submit, my manager will get that request in their Workday inbox, and they can enter any comments, send my request back with any suggested modifications, deny the request, or approve or otherwise modify. Once they've approved, on my calendar, I'll see a green checkbox next to the submission. In this example, I've already submitted a request for February 14th and 15th. But let's say that I didn't take as many hours off as I had requested on the 14th and 15th, and I had to start my vacation a little bit later than I wanted to. Whenever I click on a piece on my calendar and approve a request like I just did, Workday will immediately take me to the correct absence screen. And this is where I can edit quantities per day, or if I click on the minus button, I can remove an entire row, which removes an entire day. If I didn't start my vacation until Friday in this example, so I didn't need to take February 14th off, I can delete that day. And again, I can enter any comments. And this submission will go to my manager to either correct, send back, or approve. And as you can see, I deleted Thursday, February 14th. Workday turned that back to a submitted vacation day, and the row is grayed out. Again, until my manager approves that, it will not fall off the calendar. But I still had February 15th approved, and it will remain in Workday. I didn't change anything on February 15th. With this calendar, what I can do at the end of the month is audit this against my timesheet in ePayroll. I can either print out this calendar, or I could open both windows, see what I'm approved for, and submit through ePayroll at the end of the month. Again, Workday does not replace our current timekeeping system. We still, at the end of the month, need to go in and enter that time. What Workday provides is a single calendar and a way for you to view your teammates' approved leave or yours, and it provides tracking to see where requests have been submitted and where those requests are in the process. And it's also not designed to replace any conversations you may need to have with your team, your supervisor, or any other considerations you need to take if you're deciding to take time off and if you're going to be out of the office. So please continue to have those conversations. Talk to your team, talk to your supervisor, do what you're doing now to communicate. Workday is intended to document and track. So in this webinar, we've covered how to request an absence through Workday, how to view the different calendars, and how you can correct absences once submitted. Thanks for attending this Fast 15. Hope you have a great day.